busy day for you. Tomorrow is our health and opportunities fair, and we start off at 10 a.m. and we go straight up to 3. Tomorrow evening at 7 p.m., will be our evangelistic service, and we are anticipating another great time in the Lord. Amen, everybody? On Wednesday, what is happening on Wednesday? On Wednesday at 3:30 p.m. will be a massive youth rally. Can we hear all the youth? Praise the Lord. All right, the young and the young at heart, and those who want to be young at heart, we're not going to leave you out. If you have some time tomorrow, you're off from work this week, we're asking you, please, on Wednesday, please to come and support the students. Students, we expect to see you in your full numbers, in your uniform, representing your school. And your rally starts at 3:30 p.m. And on Wednesday will be the final night of the feast. And we cannot afford to miss the outpouring, the continuation of the outpouring of the Holy Ghost in this place. God bless you in Jesus' name.
And also in the way of announcement, in case you need to be registered tomorrow and Wednesday to put on your father's name, which is the name of Jesus Christ, come and be registered. We are here ready to register you and to give you the correct name. And we must tell you that it's free of cost. You don't have to pay. Amen. Come, hushers. We are going to collect the offering. And also for those who have invited and you are not here, we welcome you. Brother, we know you are watching, and so we welcome you in the name of Jesus Christ. God bless you. Come, hushers. I'm going to pray because you're walking slowly. Our Father, our God, our Savior, our King, our Lord and Redeemer and Creator. Lord, we come before thy throne giving you thanks for all that you have done for us. And as so we're about to collect an offering, oh God, in aid of the church building, we ask you, Lord Jesus, that you will do accordingly, that you will finance us, Lord God, in a special way. We thank you for those who give and those who give not, that they will give their heart and their soul to you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Praise team.
And as the ushers are going across, I don't normally do this, but I'm really going to ask that we give a very, very special offering. In fact, I ask tonight that we sacrifice over the next couple of days. You might well imagine what it would cost to host this conference, but separate and apart from that, we really want to use this conference, this convention, to start a very special fund. And you will hear from our brethren from Africa tomorrow. They are here. You recall that 1 year ago, we were in Africa. And as I stand before you tonight, there are 27 assemblies, churches associated with us. And there is a great work to be done over there in Africa. I want us to make a very special contribution tonight, tomorrow night, and Wednesday night. And we want to use this as the seed to kickstart a great move over there in building and expanding the work of the living God. So this will be that seed that we're going to just plant. And we are going to allow God to use it to do a great work here, and especially in Africa. And so I want us not to give the smallest that we have, but I want us to sacrifice tonight and give our best and do the same tomorrow. And we're going to do the same on Wednesday, and we're going to see where God takes us from there. God bless you as I make this plea. Give cheerfully to the Lord. God bless you in Jesus' name.
Get on the glory road. Heaven is now in view. Although the road be rough and tough, Jesus will carry you through. Holding you by the hand over in that great land. Get on.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You may be seated. Hold it. Oh, my God. You're all that tired. It's Christ. Amen. Amen. At this time, the Faith Apostolic Ministry Choir is going to minister to us. And so we're going to give some of the choir members some time to get over. You know, to get over. Give them some time to get over. The scripture says, "Five were foolish, but the part that I love says that, and when they went to buy, the door was shut. And when they went to buy, the door was shut. And when Jesus shut the door, no man opens." When Jesus shut the ark door, no matter how they cried, and Noah's heart yearned for his family, but there was nothing that he could do because the door was shut. Think on those words as I present the choir and the Holy Ghost to you in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Yeah. Hallelujah. 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 Higher ground. I'm pressing on the upward way. New heights I'm gaining. Yeah.
no kosa. Just lift me up, Jesus. Send no kosa na mata. Just lift me up, Jesus. Just lift me up, Jesus. Bashanda sanda. Just lift me up, Jesus.
The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Hallelujah. The Spirit of the Lord is in this place. Lord, lift me up, Jesus. Lift me up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Holy God, holy God, holy God. Let's lift our hands to the Lord one more time and magnify the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. The power of the Lord is in this place. He says, one shall chase 1,000, and 2, 10,000 to flight. Blessed Jesus. Hallelujah. It's now time for us to eat. Time for us to dine. It's eating time. It's lunch time. It's dinner time. It's supper time. Hey, Yodobosaya. And we're gonna eat. Hallelujah. This year is hurting me, but I'm still gonna eat. Because no weapon that form against the people of God shall prosper. And I'm not gonna let the enemy stop me from praising God. Because we're gonna eat. And at this time, I'm gonna ask our Pastor Daly to come and to introduce the speaker to you in the name of the Lord Jesus.
Praise God. We thank the Lord for his rich presence in the house from the very beginning. If the Holy Ghost is not here, we would have been wasting our time. So we glorify God for his rich presence. I love to feel God moving in my heart. I love to feel and sense and know that God is around, and we are happy tonight for his great and awesome presence in the house. We are very happy tonight, having worshiped him, to be at a point where we can hear from heaven one more time. We were tremendously blessed yesterday morning We were tremendously blessed last night. But then Sunday is past, and today is Monday. And like I said last night, and I believe many of us might say the same thing, I'm a greedy individual when it comes to the word of Almighty God. I'm craven, and I don't care what anybody want to say about that. And so I feel that I want more of the word tonight. It is my privilege and opportunity tonight to bring to this podium to minister the words of the living God to the people of God, one, and to those that are unsaved. I know that there is power in the word to bring deliverance from situations that you might find yourself in. So I want to remove myself at this time and invite to come to this podium to minister under the unction and influence of the Holy Ghost. Saints of the Most High God, please welcome at this time to minister the word of God all the way from the Cayman Islands, Bishop Dolbert, Clarke, and the Holy Ghost. Receive him in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ.
Lift your hands, everybody. Lift your hands to the King of Kings, and the Lord of Lords, the mighty conquering Lion of the tribe of Judah, the one who promised to break the chains and to set the prisoners free. He is the all-wise, all-powerful, immutable, which means he is the unchanging God, the rock of all the ages. He is a sun, he is a moon, he is a star. The brightest of them all. What a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. He is awesome. His presence is in this room. Hallelujah. Slip your antennas up as if you're saying, Lord, I am over here. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm over here. I'm over here. I need you. I need you. Lift your voices one more time in saying thank you for your presence that you have ushered in this arena. Your presence is very much, very much here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We magnify him. We magnify him. He is the first. He is the last. He is the only God, the Father of all creation, never failing, ever living. Hallelujah. 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 While you're standing on your feet, let me honor the Spirit of God that is very much in this room at this time. Hallelujah. Extending greetings to Bishop Grizzle and his dear wife. Amen. Your angel and pastor, Reverend Daly, wife and family, praise God. Amen. Bishop McHugh, and to the colleges of bishops and clergies that are standing on the platform, to the choristers, musicians and technicians, multimedia personnels, and to all the saints of God of light, precious faith, to all those who have come to lift up Jesus tonight in the beauty of holiness. Hallelujah. It is such a thrill to be in his presence. Amen. I don't know how I get here, but I am here. It wasn't planned. It wasn't organized. It just happened. But I'm glad to be here. Amen. My wife is with me. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. So glad she was able to make it with me. We're coming from England. We just barely breathe and pack and move on to Jamaica. Amen. But we're glad to be here. Amen. From the Cayman Islands, there are quite a few folks that came on. Amen. God bless them. Amen. Praise God. Pastor Clayton is here with me. My daughter, Sister Sharon. And of course, the father of Junior Clayton, pastoring some churches around in Kingston, Jamaica. He joined his son to be with us tonight. He's sitting over there. God bless him. Amen. What a joy it is to be in the presence of the Lord. Having all the overseers and bishops and pastors and shouters and supervisors and deputizers and clappers and singers and runners and mourners and weepers and dancers and givers and receivers. Put your hands together. Give the Lord a great big hand of praise. My God, what a choir. Amen. What great singing we have heard here tonight. Come on, put your hands together again for our lead singers and the choristers that stood behind them. My God, God is awesome. God is awesome. Let everyone stand to your feet if you don't have a baby in your hands, and just give the Lord everything that's left. Amen. Praise God. Praise God. Praise God. I've already told you, I don't know how I get here, but I'm here, and I'm here to lift up the name of the Lord Jesus Christ with you. Amen. You have your Bibles. Turn with me, please, to the book of Revelation. The book of Revelation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Revelation chapter 13. Revelation chapter 13. When you find it, say amen. Let's read from about the 12th verse. Amen. Let's read from verse 12, everybody together. And he exerciseth all the power of the first beast before him, and causeth the earth and them which dwell therein to worship the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed. Verse 13, and he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men. Verse 15, and he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause it, and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast should be killed. Let the church say, should be killed. And I also want to include chapter 17 of the same book, that's Revelation, to the message. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. I say message because a message is much shorter than a sermon. And I know you don't want us to drag you tonight. You are here to be blessed. And so you want to get right to the meat of the matter. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. I'd like to ask that you point your right hand in this direction and ask the Lord. I know you did it before, but you're going to do it again. Ask the Lord to give us a word in the house tonight. Stretch those faith-filled, faithful hands of yours right in this direction and ask God to cover this lump of clay. Paul was the most oratorical speaker ever to have preached on a religious lectern, but he would never preach until he begged for unction, that the people would pray that he would be unctionized to function in exegeting the words of the Lord to the souls of the people of God. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. So do it one more time. Say it from your spirit. God, anoint this lump of clay. Hallelujah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. God is still God, and he's God all by himself. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. He don't need anybody else to complete him. He is not a demi-God. He is not Jesus Jr. He is God all by himself. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. The Bible says, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord to the glory of God. If Jesus is not God, he is not Lord at all. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. When we talk about our God, we're talking about the only true creator. We're talking about the only being that has the seen and the unseen in his hands. The Bible said the earth is his footstool. Come on, somebody. The heaven is his throne room. Come on, somebody. He is so high, you can't get on top of him. He is so wide, you can't get around him. Hallelujah. He is so deep, you can't get beneath him. That's the kind of God I am talking about. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. I am not sure that we have to preach with a topic every time we preach and expect God to touch, to heal, to deliver, to miraculously save his people. But if you so desire that we use topics and theme, we can do that as you pray. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. I'd like to use a simple topic. Watch that spirit. And I heard somebody who is sharply thinking, asking, what spirit? There are many spirits, but I think we could look at the spirit of Babylon at this time. I learned you are having an end time meeting. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And I can tell you this tonight, that we are at the end of the end. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. The church is about to take off. The ecclesia, the called out body of Christ, is about to take off. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. For those who were getting ready, it's time that we get ready. The time clock is striking the midnight hour. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. There was a time when most of our preachers, they were all over the place on airplanes and trains and ships, and calls themselves prophecy teacher. You remember those days? Oh, bless the name of the Lord. They taught on the subject of prophecy until it became stale, and majority of them, they stopped. Come on, somebody. But I want to remind you that there is no end to prophecy, because the entire Bible is a prophetic book. It's a book of prophecy. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. It is where God spoke through men to men to creation. Amen. Praise the name of the Lord. And as we begin to talk about prophecy, I like to remind us that even for us to be here existing tonight, it is a prophecy. It is the fulfillment of prophecy. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. When I ask your shepherd today, amen, should I teach or preach? I think he said preach. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And I am excited to know that God is moving in Kingston, Jamaica. He is filling men and women with the Holy Ghost. Look at somebody and tell them it's harvest time. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Well, when we talk about prophecy, I know that a lot of you do look for exegetical, hermeneutical, pedagogical released most of the time. And we can do that if it's necessary. But I think it's more important that we get the word across sometimes as simple as we possibly can. Come on, somebody. Because there are dying souls in our world today that need it, and need it just like that. Praise the name of the Lord. We have, I think, about five types of prophecy. And in a teaching format, maybe we would be able to spend a little more time with it. You know, teaching is explaining. Preaching is proclaiming. And so, you know, there are seven levels or seven anointing. The anointing to preach, the anointing to teach, the anointing to heal, the anointing to deliver, the anointing to give, the anointing to receive, the anointing to praise and to worship God. Hallelujah. I don't think you are equipped to preach or to teach until the anointing sit on you. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And I am very sure that there are many clergy, members of the clergy that are here tonight in this beautiful arena filled with the people of God who are well learned and maybe would even do a better job than myself. But it's my time. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And so we're going to preach with one mouth, but many hearts agreeing together. You know, you have it hard sometimes when you want to deliver the word and you're dealing with men who know the word, just coming from the Elijah's cave with fresh revelation. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And you know that there are men who, they are great rhetorical speaker, but they only preach when they are in the lectern. And that makes it a little more difficult for the word to reach somebody who is hungry in the back. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. You would think some of us were very old sometimes when we're not in the lectern. But put us up there and you'll know we're not old. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. And there are others of us, when we come, we're so theologically equipped that we would have our pen taking notes, not praying that God send a word to somebody who is thirsty and hungry, but taking notes to go back to our congregation Sunday morning to show them how well we fasted throughout the week. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. The devil is a liar. We are here tonight to fight one devil. One devil. Hallelujah. And so we must come in agreement by the authority of the word of God and fight together. It doesn't really matter who killed Goliath. What is important, Goliath is dead. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. That's my concern. Oh, praise the Lord. Whether it be David or Jonathan or Solomon, who is going to throw a rock from a rock, I don't care. My matter and concern, it is that Goliath must fall down and he must lose his head. That's what I'm concerned about. So you can right now square your shoulders, throw your heads back, and begin to give God some praise in the house, as if you are expecting God to do something in the house. Look at somebody and tell him right now, the spirit of expectancy is the breathing ground for miracle. Come on, repeat that to somebody. Say it in somebody's ears. The spirit of expectancy is the breathing ground for miracle. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. So as you talk about prophecy, let me just remind the prophet and the prophecy teachers that God is the head of all prophecy, amen, that came down to heaven, from heaven to man. Hallelujah. In our very common closets, we have, I think, about five types of prophecy. We have conferral prophecy, and we have correctional prophecy. We have a directional prophecy, and we have confirmational prophecy. Number five, we have judgmental prophecy. Conferral prophecy, Apostle Paul writes to Timothy in this order. He said, do not neglect the gift that is in you, which was given to you by prophecy with the laying on of the hands of eldership. 1 Timothy 4 and verse 14. This gift was conferred by the Holy Spirit through the laying on of the hands of the presbytery. The last one, it is judgmental prophecy. So you see here, the prophecy line will not hinder God from moving, for God is the head prophet. Hallelujah. And if it's going to be prophecy, it should be from heaven. If it's not from heaven, the prophet should be stoned. Hallelujah. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Judgmental prophecy. Apostle Peter, by prophecy, spoke to the lying spirit of Ananias with Sapphira, his wife. Apostle Peter said, Ananias, why had Satan fill your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and to keep back part of the price of the land for yourself? I believe those who have prayed for this meeting and have organized this meeting have prayed with a vision. And they have an expectation to see God deliver the bound. Hallelujah. To set the captives free. Do I have a witness in the house? Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Babylon as a system is covered with an external grandeur and glory that attracts the natural heart and imagination of man, dazzling and bewildering him beyond beggarly description. Babylon refers to the network of evil spiritual powers that seeks to control. Hallelujah. Man man's mind. That's what the devil wants to control. He wants to control man's value. He wants to control man's belief system. He wants to control man's destiny. It is a spirit. Let me remind you folks, as you fight, remember this battle is a spiritual battle. Paul said, you wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, and against the rulers of the darkness of this world. The spirit of Babylon is the spirit of Antichrist. And in the end, we recognize that this spirit is going to brighten up its color. Hallelujah. He is going to oppose the church and everything that is called Christ. The influence of demonic spirit can be seen in every crevic, nook, and cranny of the arena. We want the devil to know that as one God, oneness, apostolic Christian, we're not just a bunch of jumpers and shouters and clappers, but we know what's going on in the underworld. Come on, somebody. So we are going to have to stay in the spirit. And so when the trump of God is sounded, when the shofar has been blown by Gabriel, we can slip off with the congregation of heaven. For Paul didn't hide it. He said, the trump of God shall sound, and the dead in Christ shall arise first. But before the trumpet has been blown, you've got a work to do. There has got to be a preparation. So the influence of demonic spirits can be seen in the educational institution, in the economic system, in the political system, unbiblical religious organization are breathing more than the mosquitoes that you talk about tonight. Come on, somebody. And I was really moved by what you said about the mosquitoes. But you need to understand that the mosquitoes, they only drink blood. Come on, somebody. And the only song I heard them singing is nothing but the blood. And if the church could rise up and start to use the blood like the mosquito, we would be able to conquer that devil that is trying to crush us. Somebody open up your mouth and shout the blood of Jesus. Yes, the blood still work. The blood still work against all these powers that are trying to drown the church and to drown the body of Christ. We need the blood of Jesus Christ. So we have, through the spirit of Babylon, the spirit of Antichrist, unbiblical religious organization rising up. We have floods of people. In China, we have about 1.2 billion people. In India, we have about 1.1 billion. In Indonesia, we have the third largest group of people. And majority of these people have not known Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. It is time for you to get the burden with your pastor, and that you want to go out into Africa, where there are thousands who have not yet heard the word of God, where the devil is like a roaring lion acting as if he's a carnivorous beast. Come on, somebody. Slap somebody and tell him it's time to get up out of your comfortable chair, rise up and fight. It's time to fight. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. In the book of Revelation, chapter 17, we see a woman here that depicts the spirit of Babylon. This woman in Revelation 17 wore still. She holds in her hand a golden cup. How tempting. The cup is gold, but its contents reveal the depths of the iniquity to which she sunk. The woman's cup was full of abominations and the unclean things of her fornication. Let's not forget, folks, that when Lucifer decided that he wouldn't be God's assistant, he wouldn't be like God, he wanted to be God, God kicked him out of heaven. And the Bible said he came down to earth angry. The Bible said, I see him falling down like lightning. Let's remember, he didn't just leave heaven all by himself. But he walked about in heaven with his beauty, with his power. And he sowed discord among the body of Christ. Come on, somebody. Before you know it, one third of the heaven, which could be trillions, have turned against God because of the lie of the father of lie was Lucifer. Not Lucifer anymore, but Abaddon, the dragon, the snake, the serpent that is after your soul, is after your finance, is after your health, is after everything that's good in your life, even your unborn baby and your mother-in-law too. You can sit down and play cute and stiff and stush like crackers. There is a devil behind you roaring. He wants to crack your soul. Come on, he knows the scripture well. I said the devil knows the scripture well. He knows that the end of all things is at hand, and so he is very busy with Antichrist and Jezebel, death and hell, his three assistants. He's working hard in every crevice, nook and cranny of the universe. He lives in the second heaven. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. I was telling somebody that the spirits that had left heaven with Lucifer was so much that they couldn't hold down here. God had to give them a world for themselves. Not one, not two, but trillions. There are more demons in our world more than the human being. You don't hear what I'm saying. Jesus saw one at Gadara, and when Jesus faced him, he cried out. Jesus asked him his name. He said, my name is Legion, for we are many. As we begin to talk about end time, the devil is angry with us because he knows that we are revealing the secrets of hell, and people are getting saved, getting filled with the Holy Ghost, coming out of the nasty hole packed with mess, dust, and trash, knowing that Jesus is Lord. Come on, somebody. It's high time, not a time to sleep, not a time to slumber, but it's high time to rise. Look at someone and tell him, I'm going back to the future. Do I have a bunch of clergy back here who is ready to preach? Tell somebody we're fighting one devil. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. And I've already begun to think that after this meeting, here the prophecy begins. You men won't go back to your organization or your congregation with the same level of anointing. But you might be going back to your congregation with the seven anointing on your life. You're going to preach more, teach more, heal more, give more, receive more, bless more, praise more, worship more. Come on, somebody. Open your mouth and let the devil know you're not dead. And if somebody's sitting beside you looking stiff and stush, oh, bless the name of the Lord. Sit down and let's talk for a few more minutes. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. But sometimes you are out there on the field like this, and you have all kinds of spirit that hook themselves up in the service, ready to hinder the outpouring of the Holy Ghost. But we come to tell every spirit that would try to hinder the flow of the power and the anointing of the Holy Ghost, you better back up. Come on, somebody. Tell them, back up. I want my power and I want it now. I want my breakthrough and I want it now. I want my healing and I want it now. I want my deliverance and I want it now. Somebody say now. Sit down, let's talk for a few minutes. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Because you see, the devil wants to put us to sleep, but it's high time now. So somebody say, this woman, she looked good. She dressed good. She do have diamonds and gold, but she is not it. Come on, somebody. When Lucifer came down here to earth, I don't know if you're ready for this, but when Lucifer came down here, he saw Adam in the garden, made in the image of God, a huge man, standing 19 foot tall. Come on, somebody. Well, it might baffle you, but the Bible tells me that Saul was taller than every man in his time in Israel, head and shoulder. The tall and handsome leader. Come on, somebody. And I know what it means. It means he was taller. That's what it meant. Well, I realize Adam was above everything in the garden, both with intellectual power, spiritual power, and in body height. The giraffe is about 13 foot tall. That means Adam could be about 19 foot tall. Come on, somebody. He didn't come through a woman's womb. He was too big. Come on, somebody. It was a handiwork done by the master himself. Come on, somebody. Look at someone and tell him that I'm not who you think I am. I am who God say I am. And no weapon formed against me shall prosper. Oh, bless the name of the Lord. Somebody said, this woman. Oh, this woman. This woman. The woman's cup was full of abomination. In the end time, we're going to be having abominable spirits filling our society, even creeping into our churches. Can I preach like I feel? And the unclean things of her fornication fill the earth. These two evils, idolatry and corruption, characterizes the last phase of the professing church of the earth, the end time church. Abomination refers to idolatry, according to Ezekiel 16 and verse 36. Fornication refers to gross corruption, Revelation 2:21. This woman is witness as the embodiment of error, immorality, and wickedness. She is now sitting on a high place. She is called Mystery Babylon. Watch them pope. Watch those rules coming out of the papacy. Come on, somebody. This spirit is a religious spirit. It goes to church. Come on, somebody. I want you to get real here. I used to think the devil was an ugly man with two black horns, a long red tail, and some dirty teeth. But then I got back to the scripture, and I look in Isaiah, when the prophet asked, oh, bless the name of the Lord, concerning this great man of beauty, an angel of beauty. The Bible said that God made him with even musical equipments on the inside. Come on, somebody. The psaltery, the sackbut, the organs, everything was in him. Go to Hollywood right now and see how handsome and how beautiful beautiful superstars we have in the Hollywood movement. They are so beautiful and handsome that if you don't mind, you want to leave the church for them. The devil is a liar. The devil was made a light. Come on, somebody. But he got messed up after a time, and so he has lost his privilege and power. Somebody should reveal him. The woman, she is the mother of harlot and the abomination of the earth. She is the parent, the source of each and every religious system which courts and marries the world. She represents religious idolatry of every shape, form, and object used by Satan to turn men from God. I believe it is God who gave you this end time theme for this end time, the revival, not only in your church, but right across Jamaica. Because I'm telling you, what's going to happen in the arena is not just going to affect one organization. It's going to affect UPC, Baptist, Catholic. It's going to affect the very witchcraft headquarters. Oh, it's going to go down to Trench Town and Tivoli and Rima. It's going to affect every gun, every knife, every bum, every good man, every bad man, every rasta man, every obia man, every crook, every hypocrite. Somebody said a blood. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Look at somebody and open your mouth and shout. I've got power through the blood of Jesus. My God Almighty. Yes, Christians will encounter the spiritual powers of Babylon in the last days. The Bible called Babylon the great harlot, with whom the kings of the earth committed fornication, and the inhabitants of the earth were made drunk with the wine of her fornication. Revelation 17:1-2. Not only is Babylon a place of gross immorality, but it is also filled with the spirit of blasphemy. Revelation 17:3. Blasphemy. Somebody said blasphemy. Humanism. Deception. My God Almighty. Idolatry. Corruption. Do you want more corruption in the street? It is even in the church house, to the White House, in the crack house, in the House of Parliament. Come on, somebody. But as God is getting the church ready, he's sounding the alarm that men will know that not until you begin to look at what is happening around you and begin to talk about it, you're not anything that you're afraid to confront, you cannot conquer. Come on, somebody. This end time revival demand some bold warriors. I don't hear the folks. Bishops and pastors and teachers, if your knees are knocking already, you better pack up. You ain't gonna make it. You need to be bold. You need to be strong. You need to be vibrant. My God Almighty. So in Revelation 17:1-2, not only is Babylon a place of gross immorality, but it is also filled with the spirit of blasphemy. Yes, deception, idolatry, corruption, uncleanness, fornication, false power, false prophets, persecution, cruelty, demonic spirits, the Antichrist, all that is perverse, abominable, and unacceptable to God is found in Babylon. Babylon is a culture. Babylon is a value system. It is a spirit. It is an attitude. Hates righteousness. Babylon is a prison house of demonic
powers. It houses every foul spirit and every unclean, hated bird. My God Almighty, somebody better pray right now. For I heard the devil said, you are rattling my feather. Devil, we are not here just to rattle your feather. We are here to lick out every feather from underneath your wing. For you have my son under your grip and my daughter trapped by homosexuality. Oh. By lesbianism and prostitution. Somebody open up your mouth and throw your head back and shout. Let my people go. Whenever you hear the word let, it means to loose, it means to release. You notice some people, they are trapped, so trapped that they can't even praise God when they come to church. It doesn't matter how you turn the fire up, it's the more they sleep. They are trapped by the spirit of Babylon. Look at somebody and ask, who are you? Who are you? What's driving you? What spirit is in you? Come on, somebody. The same old trick that was worked in the Garden of Eden, it's been worked today on us. The devil wants us to fight one another, hate one another. Can I preach here? Come on, somebody. It ain't gonna work when the choirs, the choiresters are competing. Who can sing the most? And the preachers are wondering who can preach the more. The devil is a liar. We're fighting one devil to pull out the casualties out of the hand of the devil. Don't look at me like that. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. Somebody say revelation time. Revelation time. My God, in the end time, we've got to be equipped to preach, equipped to pray, equipped to fast, equipped to heal. Come on, healing is the children's bread. Come on, somebody. The devil is after the church. He's after the unity. Come on, somebody. I wonder how Cain and Abel, two brothers, they owned the entire planet with all the gold, all the diamonds, all the silver, all the coal. They owns everything. Yet Cain killed Abel. It's a spirit of covetousness. It's a spirit of jealousy. It's a spirit of envy. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. We want to strip ourselves of every unclean, abominable demons that we might be able to serve the Lord. Don't bother try to hold me now because I know I'm telling the truth. Who are you? What spirit is driving you? Make sure it's the spirit of the Lord. I'm trying to follow my notes, but I feel something pushing me. My God Almighty. Let me hope that you didn't just come for information. We brought information, but sometimes we can't keep up with the information. For there is a pull and there is a push. Come on, somebody. You don't better come to check me out. God checked me out already. Look at somebody and tell him, I know who I am. I know who called me. My God, the devil wants to have you sitting down in church, scared to raise your hand, scared to say hallelujah. slapped somebody up and said, I've got to praise. I've got to praise the Lord. Now. Demonic spirit are prevalent. Why not say the blood in the balcony? Why not shout the blood in the ministerial chair? Why not shout the blood in the audience? The devil wants to have us trapped. But the devil is a liar, and his mother-in-law too. Come on, somebody. Come on, somebody. All that is perverse and abominable is released. Babylon is a prison house, a house of demonic powers. It houses every false spirit and every unclean, hated bird. The Babylonian spirit encompasses all the evil in the pit of hell that is injected into the culture. Can we take a look at the things that are happening around us right now? We can't even keep up with them. My God Almighty. Can I take two more minutes and talk to the people of God? For fear I don't get the chance to see you tomorrow or to say another word to you, I want to make sure I say what I'm supposed to say to you, that even if you make or have signed contract with the devil, tonight, you're going to quit. Come on, somebody. Whether it be skull and bone, lodge or Freemasonry. Hallelujah. Black magic or white magic. Come on, somebody. Somebody's going to quit tonight. You're going to change your boss. Slap somebody and tell him, change your boss. Come on, somebody. Romans said, be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed. I wish I have an apostolic group around me. Shataya, my God Almighty. Be ye not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind. Somebody open up your mouth and I used to hear that when you get a credential, you don't have to speak in tongues anymore. When you become the chairman of the county, you don't have to speak in tongues anymore. But my God Almighty, I notice when you sit in them 747 jets, and they are coming down nose away, you don't sit and fall asleep. You call on the blood, whether you be a bishop or overseer, black or white. Kashaya, for when trouble take you, bikini shirt fit you. When trouble take you, children's clothes fit you. Shandabako, the devil is in your bedroom, he's in your bathroom, trying to rip you off. Shandabako. Somebody open up your mouth. Somebody open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. When you open your mouth, I know life is there. I know you're intelligent. Yes, Mr. Intelligentsia. I know you have all the degrees. Like the thermometer. Come on, somebody. But in time like this, you need the anointing. In time like this, you need more power than the ever-ready bots. Shakama. Hallelujah. Somebody shout power over there. Power over there. Power. Mm. Look at someone and tell him, the grave, the tomb is empty. My God Almighty, I have walked into the tomb of Jesus 17 times. 17 times. Come on, somebody. 17 trips. And I never missed the tomb on one of these trips. And every time I stand in the tomb, I turn around and shake myself. Come on, somebody. You don't tell me that you step in the tomb of Jesus 17 times and come to Kingston, Jamaica, backing up from guns and knives and bombs and obeyman, Katashaya. Open your mouth and shout the blood. Blood, 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 blood. Blood in arena. Blood in Tivoli. Blood, blood. Open up your mouth. Somebody shout. My God, hear me, church. Hear me now, church. You understand that the spirit of the adversary is trying to crush you. Don't want you to have the fire of God ready on your lips. That's why we ask you to keep a praise going on. I know you're a teacher. I know you're a clerk of the court. Hallelujah. I know you're a judge. I know you drive a 7 Series BMW and the latest Mercedes Benz. I know you run a company. Come on, with staff. A staff of maybe 100 and so forth and so on. I know you have a lot of money in the bank. But we push them in the altar. And 6 bears carry them too. It doesn't matter how much money you have. You keep some praise going up to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Hallelujah. And for those of you who have been visiting church for entertainment, I'm reminding you tonight, you better run for your life before the time of too late. If you won't come alone, 7 of you will get up here. You don't hear what I'm saying. 6 pallbearer and a man in the black, dress on his back, looking good, smiling and don't even know it. Come on, somebody. Look at someone and tell him, get ready, get ready, get ready. Get ready, get ready, get ready, get ready. The church is about to leave. I said that. My God Almighty. So much things are happening around us. They baffle us. Beggarly description. We can't even keep up with them. It's time that the church gets sober. Run, sinner, run. My God Almighty. The Bible said he had power. This man had power. The beast, this woman, this, oh, hallelujah, had power to give life unto the image of the beast. Somebody said the beast. The beast is here. I said the beast is here. He is here. The Antichrist is here. He's about to overrun the church. Look what the ISIS is doing over in the Middle East. They are killing the Christian like you're killing mosquitoes. Come on, somebody. It's a sign that the church is about to be raptured. So he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship the image of the beast, that he should be killed. My God Almighty. Since the image is able to speak, look at someone and tell them, the image is a system. We have a system here that is called the computerized system, or the computer system. John saw it but never knew the name. Come on, somebody. It's wrapping up time. You've got to stay alive. Look at someone and say, stay alive. I'm going to stay on this for a little while. My God Almighty. God is getting getting a people ready. He's getting the church ready. How did you get in this arena? It's not for fun. It's serious. Maybe before this meeting is over, it could have been that maybe at the end of this meeting, there is going to be a rapturing of the church. Somebody get ready. My God Almighty, things are happening so fast that we can't even keep up with them. Am I right? My God, the processing power and speed of the computers is growing each and every year. IBM's Roadrunner computer has just shattered the previous speed record. It enables processing 1.026 quadrillion calculation per second. That is over 1,000 trillion calculations per second. The previous record was held by another IBM computer, Blue Jeans L, which could process 470.2 trillion calculation per second. Personally, I believe, and I have a right to my own opinion as a preacher, that the Antichrist will enslave and control Earth's billions of inhabitants through such an all-knowing monstrous computer, such as system is at its fingertips. As a result, he will, with unerring precision, be able to know who receives his order, obeys his commands, and honors his law. His computer also tell him who on earth rebel. You need to understand, computer is not so much a luxury. You say knowledge increase. It was when knowledge increased, the snake spoke to Eve, and she spoke to her husband, for they gave up wisdom for knowledge. And that's what is happening right now in the earth. We have given up knowledge, wisdom for knowledge. We have given up God for stuff. We have given up God for things. But God is saying, lift up your voice like a trumpet. Blow he the trumpet, bishop. Blow he the trumpet, overseers. Blow he the trumpet, superintendent. Blow he the trumpet, choirist. I heard you blowing some trumpet. My God, God's gonna double your anointing. Look at the devil and tell him you don't see nothing yet. Shataya. Come on, somebody. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. You didn't even realize that coming here tonight, you had walked by faith for a live miracle. God said, I'm going to bless you, and I'm going to bless you good. And tonight's the night. Come on, somebody. From the crowd, I feel the seven anointing working right now. Somebody open your mouth in the house. Somebody open your mouth in the house. Shut up. My God Almighty, we're going to take Kingston, Jamaica for God. Put the devil where he belongs. Shambako. Put your two finger in her two ears and echo Ifeta.
Jesus.
Ifeta, hop, Ifeta, hop, Ifeta, hop, Ifeta, hop, be healed, hop. Come on, somebody, hop. You're sitting beside, hop, a wizard, a witch, Kushandaba, hop. Check the person you're sitting beside right now, hop, and tell him I'm going to change my seat if you won't say praise the Lord, hop. My God Almighty, hop. You might as well give somebody your car key because you might not be able to drive home tonight. Come on, somebody. I feel a drunken anointing in the house right now. Somebody open him out. Open him is coming down. So there is revival in the house, revival in the bedroom, revival in your church, revival in your home, healing in your body, miracles in your life. I feel the sudden anointing sitting on me now, like a cap. Somebody says, sit on me. Open up your mouth and shout, sit on me. Yes, yes, somebody shout yes, shout yes, 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 it's your night, it's your night, shandabaka, tell the devil, shut up, you hold me down for a very long time, I wanted to go, and you wouldn't let me go, now, you come running off to me. You can't catch me again. Open your mouth. He said, if you praise me, God said, if you praise me, the wall is going to come down. Shandabako. Shandabako. I can do it. Somebody shout yes in the house. Shout blood, 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 blood. Somebody open up your mouth. Open up your mouth. Open your mouth. Shout the blood. The blood is working. Jump up on your feet. Blood is working on you now. Somebody shout the blood. Blood, 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 blood. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Shout the blood. Shut up. Labako. Shandabako. Shut up. No witch. No warlock. No coven. No gun, no knife can stand before the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth. Power is on you now. Open your mouth. Power. Somebody shout power now. Power. Open up your mouth. Shout power in here. Power now. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open my kosha. Kosha. Shandabako. Shandabako. My God, never too late for a miracle. Never too late for a miracle. Do you want it, Bishop? It's not too late. You're a young man ripe for a miracle. Shandabako. Shatama. Somebody shout the blood. Your work is not finished. Your work is not finished. Somebody better come get me. Shandabako. I said your work is not finished. Shatama. Shatamako. Shandabako. The healer is here. The healer is here. Shandabako. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Somebody open your mouth. Open your mouth over here. Shout the blood. Shout the blood. Open up, shout the blood, 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 blood. Open your mouth. 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 Shakamako. Shandabako. Yes. Yes. It's not over, Bishop. It's not over. Come on, men and bishop, hold hands. It's not over. Shandaba. I said it's not over. It's not over. Handabo. Shataba. Shandaba. Ketabo. Shandabako. The blood is working now. The blood is working. I said the blood is working. Shako. Yes, somebody shout yes. Let the church shout fire. Elijah. Elijah's fire. is in the house. Somebody shall fire. Slap, somebody shall fire. It's on your tongue, it's on your tongue. Open your mouth, no fire. Open up your mouth, it shall fire. Fire. Fire is here, fire. Somebody shall fire. Real fire. Somebody shall fire. That spirit has got to go. I said that spirit has got to go. That spirit has got to go. Somebody put your hand on your body and shout, my body is a house of the living God. Sickness has got to go. Pain has got to go. Sin has got to go. Demons has got to go. Spirit of Babylon, the blood is against you. Spirit of Babylon, spirit of homosexuality, lesbianism, and persecution, who shut up, the blood of Jesus. Stand to your feet. Stand to your feet everywhere. Those who need the Holy Ghost, slip your hand up. Let me see you. Slip your hand up. Slip your hand up. Don't be scared. Fear is the spirit of the devil. Slip your hand up. Those who need healing, slip your hand up quickly. All right, keep coming now. Keep coming to the altar. Come right now. This is your night. This is your night. Keep coming. Come on, musician, truckle now in the Holy Ghost. Shandabako. Come on, truckle in the Holy Ghost. Keep coming, keep coming. Keep coming. As you move from your seat, you're walking in your healing. You're walking in your power. You're walking in your deliverance. I prophesy. I prophesy. I prophesy your life will never be the same. Woman, go on loose from every infirmity. Give them way now. Give them way. Katabo, shut up. I prophesy. I prophesy. Give them way. Let them come. Let them come. Come from the balcony. If you can't walk down the balcony, just jump over. Kashaya. But you must get down here anyhow. Somebody in the balcony, you need to come on down here quickly. You didn't come as a spectator. Something is tugging on your spirit. Somebody's after to wrench your life away. But you have just gotten to the right place. Keep coming, keep coming. Give them way. Come on, give them way. Where is the praise and worship team? Where is the praise and worship team? Grab your microphone in your hands. Kasha, grab the minstrel. Come on, Joshua said to the people, shout. That's what he said. Shout. Shout. That's what he said. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. They're coming. Let them come. Let them come. Keep coming, keep coming. Give them way. Give them way. Kushandaba. Shatama kosha. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Give them way, give them way, give them way. Shandaba rabokosha. I don't want you to move like you're a teacher. I don't want you to move like you're a doctor. Put your doctorate degrees in your pocket and come down here. Put all those philosophical certificates in your pocket. Tomorrow you can pick them up back and overlook them, but come down here now. God said, I want to say something. I want to deposit. I want to deposit some fresh power inside of your spirit right now. Keep coming, keep coming, keep coming, keep coming. Come on, move. If you have a desire for more of God, move. Come on, church, take 30 seconds and praise God in here. Come on, take 1 minute and praise the Lord. Take 1 minute, Mr. Musician. One more minute and praise Him. Come on, somebody raise your hands and take one more minute and thank God for what He's about to do right now. Yes, 1 minute. Just 1 minute. Thank Him for what He's about to do right now. Shambo. Shambo. Healing is taking place right now. Cancer is being dried up right now. Multiple cirrhosis is being melted right now. Internal bleeding has been stopped right now. Shatamako. Witchcraft bondage has been broken now. Shandarabakosha. Glaucoma is melting right now. Cataract is disappearing right now. The blood of Jesus is at work right now. Somebody's about to speak in tongues. Open your mouth. Shatayama. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Shandabakosha. Husha. Medical scientists discovered that in the natural you die from your feet, but in the spiritual you die from your mouth. When you see somebody come to church, will I be a doctor, a lawyer, teacher, a prime minister, and will not open the mouth and say hallelujah, thank you Jesus, the blood is dead, they are dead, come on, open your mouth. He said if you open your mouth I'm going to fill you with the Holy Ghost. Somebody open your mouth. Take 30 seconds and praise him again, musician. Take 30 seconds and praise him one more time. Shandabako. Ketabohosha. Rababoshatama. Hidabarababoshayama. Yes, 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 yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Yes, yes, yes. Ooh. Yes. Yes. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. I've never seen a person feel his mouth closed. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Don't be afraid to open your mouth right now. The dove is flying. The dove is flying over you right now. I said the dove is flying right now. The dove is flying to my right. Somebody says, sit on me. Somebody says, sit on me. The dove is flying. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Shanna bako shata. Tell that doctor, open your mouth. Open your mouth. Yes, 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 yes. 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 Your body is the temple of the Lord. Get out, devil. Homosexual demons, get out. Demons of fornication, get out. Demons of adultery, get out. Stealing demons, get out. You blood murdering demons, get out now. The blood is against you. Shababako, open your mouth. Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Open your mouth in the balcony. Open your mouth in the back. Give God a praise down in the back. Give him a praise. Yes, yes, yes. 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 My God, my God, my God. My God, my God, my God. My God, my God. I came in from England tired. It's my introduction. I'll preach another night. But I want somebody to take the power now. I see the dove still flying over here. Somebody open your mouth. The dove is flying. Let the witch get the Holy Ghost. Let the wizard get the Holy Ghost. Let the gunman, let the murderer get the Holy Ghost. Let the thief get the Holy Ghost. God said, I want to fill every vase, every drug, every jar. Open your mouth. I know you're a murderer, but God will forgive you. Open your mouth. Holy Ghost is released in this place. Open your mouth. Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Let the church say yes. 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 My God. God said if you just open your mouth. That's what he said. Just open your mouth. Don't watch anybody. Just open your mouth. Open your mouth. Somebody said Jesus in the place.
You have won it all for me. Death could not hold you down.
To the next song and continue to worship. If you have been diagnosed with cancer, you're battling with cancer, we ask you right now just to leave from where you are and come around to my right. We are right now, we are going to be praying. We are going to be speaking against that spirit of cancer right now. Just wherever you are, you have been diagnosed with cancer, any kind of cancer, just come around to the side. And we are going to take you up right now. We are going to be praying with you. Praise God. Singers, worship the Lord. Cancer folks, come around. In Jesus' name, come around. In Jesus' name, come to the side. We are going to be praying. We are going to be declaring you healed and well. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Come around. Come around. Come around.
In the name of Jesus.
Yes.
In the name
yes.
of Jesus.
Yes.
We have the victory.
Mighty God, mighty God.
In the name of
yes,
Jesus.
Yes, yes, yes.
In the name of Jesus.
Devils will have to flee.
Devils will have to flee.
Mighty God,
oh,
mighty God.
Tell
yes.
me who can stand before us when we go. When we go.
Yes, yes,
in
yes.
Jesus' name.
God.
Jesus, Jesus,
precious,
precious Jesus. In the name of Jesus,
hallelujah.
We have the victory.
My God, my God.
In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus,
Jesus.
Devils will have to flee.
Oh, oh, oh.
Tell me who can stand before us
oh.
when we go. In Jesus' name, Jesus, Jesus, in the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus. Devils will have to flee.
Let God arise and his enemies be scattered.
Let God arise
and his enemies be scattered. Let God, let God arise.
Oh, let God arise
and his enemies be scattered.
Higher, from this earth to eternity. He said, "Fly, be lifted up from this earth. I was yours, come and unto me."
Sons of God, arise! Sons of God, arise! From the ends of the earth, arise!
From the ends of the earth, arise! Fire in my hands, fire in my feet, fire in my mouth, fire! Fire for the enemy, fire! Fire for the enemy! Sons of God, arise! Sons of God, arise! From the ends of the earth, arise! From the ends of the earth, arise! Fire in my hands, fire in my feet, fire in my mouth.
Receive when the